Hey there, how's it going everybody? In this video, we want to talk about how to plot a bar chart with error bars in Matplotlib and Python. And also, we want to talk about the concept, the interpretation, and the intuition that we get from these error bars. So please keep watching this video until the end of it. Let's jump into it. Okay, consider this example. Consider we have three classes, class A, class B, and class C. And we want to compare their marks. We want to compare their marks in a bar plot like this. So we have three classes, class A, class B, and class C. And we want to compare their marks. For example, we have a variable called mean marks. I mean the mean of the marks of each class. And for example, the mean for class 1 is 15. The mean for class 2, it is 18. And the mean for class 3 is 12. So the mean of the marks of class A is 15, and the mean of the marks of class B is 18, and the mean of the marks of class C is 12. There it is. And also we have another thing called STD marks, I mean the standard deviation of the marks of each class. The standard deviation of class A is 2, let's say. This is an example. It is 2, and the standard deviation for class B is 10, and the standard deviation for class C is 5. So we can see that the standard deviation of class B is significantly large, And also we can see that the mean marks, I mean the mean of the marks of class B is also higher than the other classes. There it is. Before going further, please make sure to subscribe and click the bell next to it to be notified of every new video. And to let me know, please leave a comment below that I have subscribed. After creating these two variables, I mean mean marks, which is the mean of the marks of each class, and STD marks, which is the standard deviation of the marks of each class, and this STD marks represents the heterogeneous, the spread, and the volatility of the marks of each class. After defining these two variables, we want to plot a bar chart with error bars in Matplotlib. So in order to plot something in Python, we need to import Matplotlib. So we say import Matplotlib. And remember, Matplotlib is not a built-in package. So if you want to use it, you should install it first. After installing Matplotlib, you say import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. And we are considering an alias name, which is plt, for this long-term matplotlib.pyplot. So we have imported matplotlib.pyplot as plt. So after that, we say plt.bar because you want to plot a bar plot. And we want to set our x-axis to be a, b, c. So for example, we define a variable called x, which is a list of a, b, and also C, because you want to set the x-axis of our, let's say, bar plot, A, B, C. So first of all, we pass this x to this bar plot because you want to set the x-axis to be A, B, C. And the height of our bar plot, we want to set the height of our bar plot to mean marks, So we say mean marks. And after that, we say Y, E, R, R, which is something for assigning the error bars, which we say STD marks. I mean, we want to set the error bars to standard marks. We want to denote the error by STD marks, I mean the standard deviation of the marks of each class. And after that, we say plt.show for showing the graph. And if we run the code, you can see that here's our bar chart with error bars in Python. But maybe you want to make this chart a little bit more beautiful. So maybe we can say something like this. For example, we say color, I mean the color of the bars, to be light, let's say gray, and the edge color, I mean the edge color of each bar, we want to set it to black. And if we run the code, you can see that the face color, the interior color of each bar is light gray, and the edge color is black. And maybe you want to change the color of these error bars. So we can do it like this. You say e-color, I mean error bar colors. And for example, maybe you want to set it to red. Maybe you want to set this error bar color to red. If you run the code, you can see that the colors has changed to red. And maybe you want to have some caps in these error bars. So you say, for example, capsize, you say capsize. Capsize equals, let's say, 5. And if you run a code, you can see that we have some caps in these error bars. So here's how to plot a bar chart with error bars in Python. But let's talk about the concept, about the interpretation and the intuition that we get from this bar plot and its error bars. So if you look at these bar charts and these error bars, you can see that we have three classes, class A, class B, and class C. Class B is performing better in terms of the mean marks, I mean the mean of marks of the students in each class. You know, the mean mark of class B is better. I mean, the mean of the marks of the class B students is better than the other classes. But, for example, in class A, you can see that the error bar length is not very big. You know, it is not very big. This error bar is not very lengthy. And you can see that it is very small. And it denotes that in class A, we have students with the same level. But in class B, the length of this error bar is extremely high, which denotes that, you know, it is very large. And it denotes that in class B, we have students, for example, we have students of different levels. For example, we may encounter with a student getting 20, and also we may encounter with a student getting 0. I mean, the levels of these students in this class is extremely different, because you can see that because the length of the error bar is extremely large, and you can see that the heterogeneous, I mean the volatility and the spread of the marks in class B is significantly larger than the other classes. However, in class A, you can see that this error bar is not that large, and it shows that the heterogeneous is not that much significant. So you can see that in terms of mean marks, class B is performing better. But in case of homogeneous and minimum deviation and minimum, let's say, error, you can see that class A is performing better.